Let's make color-changing lemonade and watch how particles move in liquids. First, you're going to need dry butterfly pea flowers. This is a key ingredient. You can't substitute it without dramatically changing this recipe because these flowers in particular do something special. Luckily, you can find them on Amazon. We've linked it below, and a little goes a long way. You only need 8 flowers for this recipe, and that bag is filled with flowers. We've done countless trials and are still on our first bag. Next, add in some sugar and boiling water. You're basically making a tea, so the boiling water steeps the flowers and dissolves the sugar. Let that sit for about 5 minutes, and during that time, watch it transform. Also, quick note, be sure your sugar is fully dissolved at the end. We found we needed to stir it to fully dissolve it. Remove the flowers using a spoon, and now, well, we need this to be cold because that's the whole point of lemonade. It's supposed to be refreshing. If you have some time, ideally, you'll put it in the fridge. If you need a quicker method, you can add in a bunch of ice cubes, but that will dilute it. So if you do that, we recommend just using 1 cup of boiling water instead of 1.5 cups to start with. Now for the most exciting part, the lemon juice. We really can't recommend strongly enough to use fresh lemons. It makes such a difference in flavor. Just cut them in half and then squeeze them. To make sure you have a nice juicy lemon, it should have a little bit of give like this and not like this. While you can just pour the lemon juice all in at once, we recommend doing a little bit at a time for 2 reasons. One, we found that people have really different personal preferences for how tart they want their lemonade to be. So what we recommend doing is adding a little bit, tasting it, and then adding more based on your personal preference. The cool part about this is that you can actually compare and visibly see how tart you prefer your lemonade versus someone else's. The other reason we like doing this is that you can really see the color change, and that's the beauty of this lab. Let's talk about the science. So there are 2 moments in this recipe where we see how particles in the liquid behave and move, which I'm going to be honest, when you say it like that, doesn't sound that interesting, but watching it, like seriously watching it, it's kind of magical. So the first moment is when the flowers steep in the tea, and the second is when we add the lemon juice. Particles in the liquid move freely in random directions, and these moments also demonstrate another phenomenon, diffusion. Diffusion is the movement of particles from a high concentration, crowded area with a lot of particles, in this case, actually in the flowers, to a low concentration, an area with not as many particles, in this case, the water. This movement will occur until the particles reach equilibrium, meaning equal concentrations. Although given that the particles are in a liquid, that doesn't mean that the particles stop moving. There's just not a clear flow or direction to which they're moving to. And of course, stirring further distributes the particles throughout the liquid. Now in this trial, which had honey instead of sugar, you can see that the honey collected at the bottom and we have this weird barrier or wall that formed. We're really not sure why. Any ideas? Seriously, let us know in the comments because we're not really sure what's going on. The other time we see these particles move and diffuse is when we add the lemon juice, and we also see a change in color due to pH. This is because butterfly pea flowers are a natural pH indicator, meaning they change color in reaction to pH. So at a neutral pH of 7, which is water, the flowers are blue. At an acidic pH below 7, the flowers turn pink. Red cabbage demonstrates a similar phenomenon, and we've explained all the science behind acids, bases, and pH there. You can also play around with temperature, which you're kind of already doing because the first time we see diffusion and it's in boiling water, and the second time it's in ice cold water because it's with the lemon juice. Now there are a lot of discrepancies here and it's not necessarily a controlled experiment, but you can compare and see at the temperature the particles move, or what you can even do is add in the lemon juice before you've cooled it down like we did here and you can compare the two. You can also try replacing the lemon juice and noticing what happens to the color and taste when adding in other acids, like orange juice or other fruit juices, or something that's really acidic, like citric acid. We hope you enjoyed this video. Be sure to like and subscribe for more.